In the previous episode on Rust web app production calling, we discussed how model controllers handle data access for each entity, while model manager provides the resources for model controllers to do their job. And a great question from the comments was, why distinguish between model controllers and model manager? And the short answer to this separation of concern is keep the parts simple and focused, it will scale better. Or the cute way to put it is dumb is the new smart. For example, now our model controllers are extremely straightforward. We can call them via static struct functions like taskBMC create, and then pass our model manager state as function argument. No need to worry about instances, lifetimes, or ownership when it comes to model controllers. All state-related matters are passed as arguments to these functions in a consistent way. And the model manager is responsible for managing those state's resources, such as database pool connection for now, but later we'll add other resources like Redis client, S3 clients, and even database transaction support. Model manager is typically managed at the app state level. For example, in our Axiom case, we use the Axiom states. And in fact, we also have another type of state that follows this pattern, and that is our CTX, which is more of a request command type of state. And we pass those in our model controllers functions as well. And for now, it just holds the user ID performing the command or request, but it will hold much more later. Now, since it's more kind of a request state, we are getting it via the Axiom extractor by implementing the Axiom from request parts for our CTX. But the point is that our model controllers do not have to know how those states are managed. And so both parts, the model controllers and model manager, can evolve mostly independently. Now, the beauty of Rust is that it is not an instance-first language, and that is for the better. Traits and generics are applicable at both the instance and type levels. So for example, in our base model controller module, we have a trait DBBMC at the type level, meaning no self. And for now, we just have one const, the table name. We'll have more later. Then the base model controllers can just be functions that get this information at generic input. For example, in our base create function, which is responsible to create a new entity from E for the model controller MC, in the arguments, we get our states CTX and model manager, and for this function, just the data E. And because our MC generic is of type DBBMC, and even if MC is not part of the function arguments or the return type, we can still access our generic MC property like that. And the way it works on the caller side, for example, in our task BMC, we just have our struct unit with no instance states. We implement our DBBMC trait to specify the const table name. And in our task BMC implementations, we have all our data access functions like CRUD and more. And if we look at our create function, for example, we get our states, CTX and model manager, that will pass around our data, which is task for create. And then we can call our base create function and pass the model controller type self, which is taskBMC, in the TurboFish notation. And then we pass our CTX model manager and the data. By the way, a quick side note here, we can explicitly specify the generics, taskBMC and task for create, but the second one can be inferred by the compiler from the task C argument, which is task for create. And the first one can be referred as big self, since this matches our containing type, task BMC. And voila, our model controllers can reuse the base functions. So no pseudo inheritance, no instances, and we still have shared implementations. The trick is to unlearn our instance for everything reflexes. But once we do, our con design becomes simpler, scales better, and it's even more efficient for the machine. So everybody's happy. For more, feel free to watch a full Rust web app production coding video. It's a dense one, but has some good patterns for production coding. Also, I'm aiming to transition to full-time creation of Rust production coding material, so any help is big help. Big thanks to Cram Nebula for their sponsorship. Until next one, happy coding.